The things that a fellow should look for in a training program are, you know, first getting the skills that you need to practice pulmonary and critical care medicine. And I would say without a doubt, you know, those skills are here. The ability to do procedures, to run patient family meetings, to interact in a team environment where we have nurses, nurse practitioners, respiratory therapists, and all these different people who are coming together to take care of patients and have a little autonomy and ability to make decisions about you know, what sorts of things to do for the patient on a daily basis. Those were things that I found very valuable in my training experience, and that's certainly what we try to provide for our fellows here. The other part of training is you know, just recognizing that critical care intense is in the name of the field. So a good training program recognizes this and looks out for their fellows as well too, and makes sure that fellows are doing well, that they are, that they feel fresh, and you know, despite you know working long hours, that they feel fulfilled at the end of the day, and making sure that we're in constant communication with the fellows to make sure that they're getting a good experience, and if something is not working that well, that we can change that, and they have the ability to make that change. We're a small sort of community, and we get along with each other, we like each other, and we care about each other. And I think that you know the best training environment is one that stimulates you academically and also fulfills you personally. And I think without question, our fellowship program provides that for our fellows.